Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Your subscription are always motivating us. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about fundamentals of pathology. I am going to cover the effects of pathogen on the psychological function of the plants. So it also consists of effects on photosynthesis, transpiration, respiration, as well as the translocation of water and nutrient mechanisms in the plant. So while seeing about the effects of plant pathogen on the physiological functions of the host, so the major parts as well as the major functions which it is going to interact are the photosynthesis, translocation of water and nutrients, so transpiration, respiration, permeability of cell membrane, translation, growth and reproduction of the plant cells as well as the pathogenic cells. So first we are going to see about the photosynthesis. So the first important phase, the where the pathogen which used to interfere with the pathogen photosynthesis, are the first one is chlorosis as well as then necrotic lesion as well as large necrotic area and reduced growth, as well as which leads to amount of fruit reduction as well as production of many infected plants from the particular plant. So by this photosynthesis infection, so the photosynthesis is said to be reduced because mainly due to the pathogenic infection which used to affect the chloroplast and causes their degeneration in the leaf areas. So the overall chlorophyll content of the leaf in many fungal and bacterial diseases is said to be reduced in the host plant. And while said to be the material of chloroplast is said to be reduced, and there can be a reduction of photosynthesis which is mainly due to the production of toxins such as tentotoxin as well as taptoxin by the pathogen. And these toxins which used to inhibit the sum of enzymes which are directly or indirectly involved in the photosynthesis and which used to lead the reduction in photosynthesis process of the plant. And while continuing this, the infected plant which is used to have many vascular pathogens and the stomata remains partially closed, and always the chlorophyll is said to be reduced in that particular plant. And so the photosynthesis it to be even stops before the plant eventually wilts is the physiological factor which is affected by the pathogen in the infected plant. And while seeing about them, most of the virus molecules, nematodes, diseases which includes varying of chlorophylls and chlorosis and stunning in the infected plant. In the majority of such diseases, the photosynthesis of the infected plant is said to be reduced greatly, and in advance of the diseases, the rate of photosynthesis is said to be not more than 1/4 of its normal rate. So there is a gradual reduction in photosynthesis from the start of infection to its final stage. So after that, the translocation of water and nutrients. So while seeing about the effects of the absorption of water by roots, so most of the pathogens which used to cause such as damping of fungi, root rotting fungi and bacterial nematodes and some other virus which used to cause cause an extensive destruction of root cells. So the destruction of root cells which used to cause or else show the symptom which is appear only above the ground parts of the cell. So while seeing about them, some of the bacteria and nematodes which used to cause root galls or root knots, so which used to interfere in the normal absorption of water as well as nutrients by the roots. So it used to cause root injury which used to affect the amount of functioning roots directly and decreases the amount of water uptake done by the host plant. So some of the vascular parasites which used to grow along with the other effects such as inhibiting root hair production and also reduces water absorption. And after that, so now we are going to see the particular part in the absorption is xylem translocation. So the fungal and bacterial pathogens which used to cause damping or stem rot, as well as canker which used to cause the destruction collapse of the xylem in the host plant. So, which is an example is damping off Kresik canker in older plants and particularly the older trees, and which used to cause some reduction in transfiguration of water by the organism Citrus cancer, Xanthomyinas PV, Axenopodis PV citri, and it can able to show the affected vessels which used to cease function properly and allow little or no water to pass through them in the infected host. So they used to show enlarged and proliferation cell near any things around the xylem, exert pressure on the xylem vessel which may be crushed or dislocated, and thereby becoming less efficient in transporting water to the whole plant. Example, tumors and galls, as well as club root of cabbage. So it is the picture of clogging of xylem vessels by Ralstonia pathogen. And even knowing about the xylem translocation, there in while telling it about in general for the xylem translocation, the rate of flow through infected stem, which is seen to be inversely proportional to the number of vessels which is said to be blocked by the pathogens and its compounds. So the number of vessels which is said to be blocked by the pathogen, which is said to be increases, and inversely it leads to the rate of flow of water from the normal stem. So it is said to be gradually decreasing. And in xylem translocation, the flow of water is said to be only reduced through reduction in size or collapse of the vessel due to infection, as well as the development of tilos in the vessel, which used to release large molecule compound in the vessel, which result in the cell wall breakdown by pathogenic enzymes, and also the breakdown by pathogenic enzymes, and reduce water tension in the vessels due to the pathogen induction alteration. So, which is the main cause of foliar transpiration done by the pathogen in the host plant's xylem vessels. So, after that, we are going to see about the transpiration. So, once the pathogen which used to infect the leaf transpiration, which is said to be usually increased as the result of destruction of cuticle, and there is an increase in permeability of leaf cells. So, there can which used to cause the disinfection of stomata, as well as destruction of considerable portion of the cuticle, and which used to result in epidemics of uncontrolled loss of water in the affected areas. So the function of the stomata is said to be reduced and causes the destruction of the closing portion of the stomata, which is cuticle. So there is an uncontrolled loss of water in the affected areas. So, and after that, the transpiration. Even if the water absorption and translocation cannot keep up the excess loss of water due to the destruction of stomatal cells in the plants, so there can be a loss of turgor as well as wilting of leaves. So which used to follow the section of excessive transpiring leaves are said to be increased abnormally, which leads to the collapse or dysfunction of underlying vessels. So, which leads to the production of tilos as well as gums present on the host cells. So, these are the pictures of damaging of epidermal layer by rust to reduce pores in the host pathogen. So, while seeing about them in translocation of organic nutrients through the soil. So, the first infection is only through the photosynthetic cells, and then the plasmoderma, and up to the phloem elements and phloem sieves. After that, the plasmodesmata, and the non-photosynthetic cells or the storage organs are said to be the final one, which is infected through the phloem transpirations. So after that, we are going to see about the translocation of organic nutrients through obligate parasite. So these parasites, so which used to interfere with the movement of organic nutrients from the leaf cells to the phloem, so where they can able to accumulate in the photosynthetic product as well as inorganic nutrients in the infected areas are said to be absorbed by these parasites. So the translocation of organic nutrients from healthy leaves toward the infected areas are said to be higher, so due to the parasitic infection. And now we are going to see about other pathogens. So while seeing about other pathogens, they usually destroy the phloem elements in that area, which is you thereby interfering with the downward translocation of nutrients, so of phytoplasma. So as well as in diseases caused by the phloem limited fastidious bacteria, so bacteria which used to exist and reproduce in the phloem seed tubes, so which used to cause an interfering with downward translocation of nutrients in the host cell. So these are the pictures, so of xylem and phloem, and also you can able to see the parasitoids which used to chop. I have mentioned it as PEA, so this pathogen which used to interrupt the transport of food material from upper part to the lower parts. So after that, now we are going to see about the host plant respiration. So when there is an increase in respiration which used to cause an infection in the host plant, this means the affected tissue use up the reverse carbohydrate faster than the healthy tissue would. So this increased rate of respiration which used to appear shortly mainly after the infection of the host plant. So by this, the concentration of several enzymes at the respiratory path are said to be increased during this host plant respiration. So while increased respiration in disease plant which used to accompanied by increased activation of pentose phosphate pathway, so which is the main source of phenolic compounds in the plants, but in resistant varieties respiration also decreases quickly after it reaches its maximum in the host plant respiration. So but in susceptible plants, so there is no defense mechanism is said to be mobilized, so the quick attack against a particular pathogen which used to respirate and increases slowly after the inoculation, but it usually continues to rise and remains at high level for much longer periods, so which leads to the decayation of the host plant. So after that, now we are going to see about the permeability of cell membranes affected to plant pathogenic infections. So the most commonly observed effect of changes in cell membrane of permeability is the loss of electrolyte, is that the small water soluble ions as well as the molecules of the cells are said to be reduced, and the electrolytic leakage which used to occurs much sooner and at a greater rate. So when the host pathogenic interaction is said to be incompatible, as well as the host remains more resistant than and when the host is susceptible, which used to develop an extensive symptoms. So first there must be cause of intensive damage, and only when the host plant is said to be susceptible and it used to show the extensive symptoms in the plants. And now we are going to see about the transcription translation. So the transcription and translation is mainly due to the genetic remix by the virus and fungal obligate parasites, so which is said to be mainly found in rust and powdery mildew, which used to affect the transcription process in infected cells. So the pathogen affects the transcription by changing the composition and structure as well as functions of the chromatin, which is the DNA of the host plant, is said to be changed by these pathogens. So I am first going to tell about the virus. So while seeing about the viruses, they are mainly made up of RNA modifying by host enzymes, which is RNA polymerase. So these viruses used to utilize the host cell nucleotides. So they used to make the host plant to make its own RNA, which is the activator of ribonuclease enzymes, is said to be increased by the breakdown of the host plant's RNA enzymes, is caused by these viruses. So in that, the virus used to translate, so which used to increase the activity of certain enzymes are particularly associated with the generation of respiration as well as the production of oxidation of various phenolic compounds, so some of which may be involved in defense reactions to get infected by this translation process. So I have given the lecture notes in description. If you have any doubts, please tell us in the Instagram and join by joining in the Instagram link we have given in the description. So please comment about us our video. If you like the video, like it, and share it with your friends and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video and catch up in next videos.